Som chung kui cho.
President, please be seated.
Le président, veuillez vous asseoir.
Ong chum nun chup rea, pakah ban to samanaka.
The court is now back in session.
Reprise des débats.
And the chamber now hands the floor to the lead co-lawyers for civil parties, followed by the co-prosecutors. You may proceed.
Vous avez la parole.
Je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président. Bon après-midi à tous.
Bonjour, Monsieur le témoin. Je m'appelle Marie Guiraud. Je suis avocat des parties civiles et j'ai quelques courtes questions de clarification à vous poser suite au témoignage que vous avez donné à la Chambre depuis le début de la journée. La première question que je souhaiterais vous poser a trait à votre séjour en Chine. Vous avez indiqué ce matin et cet après-midi à nouveau que vous étiez parti en Chine en 1976, mais vous n'avez jamais précisé le mois exact où vous étiez parti en Chine. Pouvez-vous indiquer à la Cour quand exactement vous êtes parti en Chine pour effectuer cette formation dont vous avez parlé tout à l'heure ?
It happened a long time ago. Cannot recall it clearly.
Je m'en souviens pas très bien.
I cannot recall the month. However, it happened in early 1976.
Je vous remercie dans votre procès-verbal d'audition dont nous avons abondamment parlé depuis le début de la journée. Vous avez indiqué en réponse 12 que vous étiez parti en Chine en janvier 1976. Est-ce que cela correspond à ce dont vous vous souvenez aujourd'hui, la date de janvier
1976? Yes, I think it is around that month.
Oui, ça doit être ça.
Vous souvenez-vous quand vous êtes rentré de Chine?
Do you remember when you returned from China?
I cannot recall the exact period, however, I returned in a rainy season.
Je suis rentré pendant la saison
and
des
pluies. That is after the Pyeong Water Festival that year.
C'était après le festival des eaux de cette année-là.
Je vous remercie. Dans le même PV d'audition, vous avez indiqué en réponse 13 que vous étiez rentré en novembre 1977. Est-ce que cela vous rafraîchit la mémoire?
Does this somehow jog your memory?
Mr. President?
Maître Kopp. Monsieur le Président.
Probably that was the time that I returned.
Oui, c'est sans doute.
Thank you.
Maître Kopp, merci.
I seek some guidance in relation to your decision as to which documents can be used with this witness. I have read your decision and I understood that both civil party lawyers and the prosecution are prohibited from using the statement of this witness. So, of course, we have been using it extensively, but is your ruling such that in fact, both civil party lawyers and the prosecution cannot refer to his statement.
Est-elle bien que ni la partie civile ni l'accusation peut se servir de ce procès-verbal?
Une clarification est effectivement nécessaire, Monsieur le Président, parce que ce n'est pas du tout la façon dont j'ai lu votre décision. Et il me semble que nous sommes parfaitement autorisés à utiliser ces déclarations et confronter le témoin à ces déclarations. Et dans le document F26 auquel je me rapporte, il n'est pas indiqué que les parties civiles et l'accusation est un traitement différent de la défense dans l'utilisation des documents. Donc je vous demande simplement de respecter la lettre de votre décision, la décision F26, et de me permettre de poser la question. Il y a déjà été répondu par le témoin, mais c'est une autre affaire.
Has already been answered, I admit, by the witness, but that's another matter.
Maybe I'm not completely correct as to the civil party lawyers, but I'm definitely sure about the decision of the chamber to prohibit the prosecution from using this document. Is that correct?
Ai-je raison?
J'attends votre indication, Monsieur le Président, pour savoir si je peux poursuivre ou non. De ce que j'ai compris de la décision F26, nous avons la possibilité d'utiliser ce document. Je vais me rasseoir peut-être et patienter.
Let me sit down and wait until you have a decision.
Just to help move things along, I believe the document probably is listed as excluded from the use of the co-prosecutors because the ERNs were not given until the next day, but that did not apply to the civil party co-lawyers, and I'll say nothing else on that right now.
Mais je ne dirai rien de plus à ce sujet pour l'instant.
May I please ask the defense? You are familiar with this record, with the document to which the civil party is referring?
Yes, we use it extensively. And I in itself don't have a problem with the civil parties using the document, although I think they didn't put it on their list. But I don't have a problem if they use it. However, you specifically prohibited the prosecution from using it, and I think the Supreme Court chamber should stick to that decision.
And Mr. Verken?
Mr. Verken?
Sir, are you? Is the defense of Kyo Samphan familiar with this record?
Connaît-elle ce document? La défense de Kyo Samphan connaît-elle ce document?
Oui, je connais le document. Enfin, moi, on me demande si je connais le document. Bien sûr, je le connais.
I am familiar with it. Yes.
And do you? Prosecution using it.
Vous
notwithstanding
vous
our prior decision on the subject.
L'accusation s'en serve, mais nonobstant notre décision préalable.
Bien sûr, Madame le juge, je m'oppose à ce que l'accusation s'en serve, tout à fait, conformément à votre décision
Madame,
et aux règles
I
que vous avez fixées.
Je crois que la prosecution ne devrait pas l'utiliser en accordance avec la décision que vous avez
prise.
President, Defense Counsel.
La défense.
In the document in Khmer is F2/411. However, on the screen that I have in front of me, it's
E319/127.
Could you please confirm whether these two IDs refer to the same document?
Deux codes font référence au même document.
Yes, the document that I've been referring to all morning is now being used by the civil party lawyers, which, again, we don't have a problem with, although it wasn't on their list. But we do have a problem with the prosecution using it because you explicitly prohibited it. If they are now allowed to use it, then the question arises, what was the point of the decision?
Indeed, Mr. Koppe, there was because of the pressure of the time, we had like two objectives in mind to allow prior statements and yet disallow documents that were too long to familiarize with them, to enable the proper familiarization of all the participants to the hearing. Considering, however, we mainly had you in mind and prevent the defense being inconvenienced by documents that were suddenly pulled out of the to the light. Let us ask the prosecution if they find this record useful or whether all the parts covered by the record were covered that they are interested in have been covered by the record. And if you still find it useful, we will quickly deliberate whether to rescind our decision with this in this area.
We don't need it, and we'd ask to just move on.
Thank you.
President, you may not proceed.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Je reprends le cours de mes questions en partant du principe que je suis autorisé, le cas échéant, à citer un autre extrait du procès-verbal d'audition du témoin auquel la défense s'est abondamment référée depuis le début de la matinée. Donc je voudrais simplement, en tout cas, reposer ma dernière question au témoin afin que celle-ci soit notée dans le procès-verbal d'audience. Monsieur le témoin, vous avez indiqué tout à l'heure que vos souvenirs étaient incertains quant à la date de retour de votre séjour en Chine. Je vous ai indiqué votre réponse 13 dans votre procès-verbal d'audition où vous citez la date de novembre 1977. Je vous demande votre réaction par rapport à cette date. Est-ce qu'elle correspond à vos souvenirs ?
Man.
Witness, it is about right.
Oui, ça me semble correct.
Lorsque vous étiez en Chine, étiez-vous mis au courant de ce qu'il se passait dans la zone nord-ouest ? Aviez-vous des moyens de vous tenir au courant ?
Abreast with what was going on in the northwest zone.
Answer no.
No.
And there was no information broadcasted over the radio about that.
Et il n'y avait aucune information à la radio à ce sujet.
Je vous remercie. Vous avez indiqué un petit peu plus tôt dans la journée, à plusieurs reprises, une conférence à laquelle Rosnim a assisté à Phnom Penh et à laquelle vous l'avez accompagné en qualité de chauffeur, me semble-t-il. Je voulais simplement vous poser des questions de suivi pour être bien sûr de la conférence dont vous parlez. Pouvez-vous indiquer à la Cour la durée de cette conférence ? Est-ce que vous en avez le souvenir ? Est-ce que c'était une journée, beaucoup plus ? Que pouvez-vous nous dire à ce sujet ?
The conference lasted for many days.
It
lasted for almost 1 month or a lot more than 1 month.
Un nombre de jours, un mois même, presque, peut-être plus qu'un
mois.
Because of time passing by, I could not recall it.
Mais cela remontait il y a longtemps et je ne me souviens pas très bien.
Où cette conférence se déroulait-elle à Phnom Penh ? Est-ce que vous en avez le souvenir ?
Can you remember where the conference took place in Phnom Penh ?
Answer, I did not know where it was held.
Je ne connaissais pas l'endroit.
After I drove him and arrived at in front of the Royal Palace, after I had a meal together with them at Borekela, I went back to my place.
La suite à Borekela, et je suis ensuite rentré chez moi.
Monsieur le Président, avec votre autorisation, je voudrais citer deux lieux qui sont cités dans un paragraphe du jugement dont Nguyen Chea et Kyo Sampan ont fait appel pour savoir si ces lieux, ces noms de lieux, évoquent quelque chose aux témoins. Le lieu de la pagode d'argent, où une réunion s'est déroulée en mai 1975, et le lieu du stade olympique. Est-ce que ces deux lieux, monsieur le témoin, vous rafraîchissent la mémoire ?
Now these two places, Mr. Witness, do they mean something to you? Do they ring a bell here?
Answer, I do not know the place where the conference was held.
Je ne sais pas où la conférence a eu lieu.
As I said, so there was someone in Phnom Penh in charge of sending him or driving him to the conference venue.
Il avait un chauffeur désigné à Phnom Penh qui le conduisait au lieu de la conférence.
Lorsque vous avez indiqué un petit peu plus tôt que la conférence a duré un mois, pouvez-vous nous dire si Rostin est resté un mois à Phnom Penh pour cette conférence? Est-ce que vous le savez?
Stayed a month in Phnom Penh for the duration of the conference. Do you know the answer to that?
Phnom Penh. Everyone, including Ruhnyum, Takke,
Tapait.
They were staying in Phnom Penh.
Ils sont restés à Phnom Penh.
Messenger and I.
Les messagers et moi-même.
Ching. Ching our shifts and some of us went back to Battam Bong to collect the rice. So we work on the roster basis until he completed
et nous avons procédé plutôt par roulement
the meeting.
Jusqu'à ce qu'il ait terminé sa réunion.
Avant votre départ en Chine en janvier 1976, est-il arrivé que vous accompagniez Rosmin à Phnom Penh à d'autres occasions que la conférence dont vous venez de parler?
To Phnom Penh on other occasions other than this conference you've just told us about?
But admin day. Answer no.
No.
No. I only drove him to Phnom Penh once.
Je ne l'ai conduit à Phnom Penh qu'une seule fois.
Et saviez-vous à l'époque si Rosnim and se rendait régulièrement à Phnom Penh ou non?
At the time if Rosnim
avant votre départ en Chine en janvier 1976.
Before you went off to China in January 1976.
Answer. After he returned to his zone, I did not know whether he visited Phnom Penh regularly.
Je ne sais pas s'il est retourné à Phnom Penh régulièrement.
Avant votre départ pour la Chine en janvier 1976, avez-vous assisté, avez-vous été témoin de visites des leaders de l'ANCAR ou du comité permanent dans votre zone?
Non.
But I do not know who was who.
Mais je ne savais pas qui ils étaient.
Vehicles.
Ils étaient dans une dans des voitures.
And the window of the vehicles
des voitures
were blackened.
Aux vitres teintées.
And only the windshield and the window at the back could be seen.
En fait, les seules vitres qui n'étaient pas teintées, c'était le pare-brise avant-garde.
And with them.
Et ils avaient des gardes de sécurité avec eux, mais je ne savais pas qui.
Vous a-t-on dit à l'époque qui composait cette délégation?
And at the time, did anybody say to you who the members of the delegation were?
But admin day. Answer. No, I did not question them.
Non,
I did not dare to ask them.
Je n'ai pas osé poser la question.
Je vous remercie. Je voudrais vous faire réagir à une disposition contenue dans le jugement, donc Yeo Sampan et Nguyen Chia ont interjeté appel. C'est le paragraphe 747 du jugement, dans lequel il est mentionné une visite du comité permanent dans la zone nord-ouest en août 1975. Est-ce que cette date d'août 1975 correspond au moment où vous avez vu ces voitures à vitre fumée dont vous parlez?
Correspond to the one in which you saw those cars with their blacked out windows.
Answer. I do not recall it, but I noticed that some of them were there. I do not recall when, what month exactly.
Là, mais je ne saurais dire quel mois.
Savez-vous ce qu'ils ont fait quand ils étaient présents?
Do you know what they did?
Quelles activités Quelle visite? Avez-vous le moindre souvenir ou simplement ces vitres fumées?
Where they visited, or did you have any idea of what was going on behind those dark windows?
Answer. I did not know where they were heading to, but I only knew that they were heading to Danyam's house at Prampi Prohau. And after they left the house, I did not know where they were going to.
Après qu'ils aient quitté la maison, je ne sais pas où ils sont.
Je vous remercie. Vous avez répondu à une question de mon confrère Copé ce matin sur Nuun Shea.
Thank you very much.
Et vous avez indiqué que vous aviez entendu son nom, mais que vous ne l'aviez jamais rencontré en face à face. Je voulais vous faire réagir à une réponse que vous avez apportée aux enquêteurs quand ils sont venus vous interroger en 2013. Et vous avez indiqué ceci, je suis en réponse 35 de votre PV d'audition, Nuun Shea et Tanim étaient amis depuis longtemps. Autrefois, ils avaient fait leurs études et se sont fait ordonner moines ensemble en Thaïlande. Que pouvez-vous nous dire, monsieur le témoin, sur les relations qu'entretenaient Nuun Shea et Tanim, en tout cas ce dont vous vous souvenez et ce dont vous saviez à l'époque?
Answer. I heard of this from my foster father. He described the background of Nuun Shea. He told me about Nuun Shea's background.
Quand vous parlez d'antécédents, c'est en tout cas le mot qui vient dans la traduction en français. Qu'entendez-vous par là? Pouvez-vous être un petit peu plus disert, bavard, si possible?
Could you give us a few more examples and ideas?
Can you repeat your question?
Pourriez-vous répéter votre question, s'il really vous plaît? Je n'ai pas très bien compris.
Bien sûr, je vous ai fait réagir à l'une de vos réponses que vous aviez données à l'époque aux enquêteurs, où vous disiez, je vous cite, ce sont les propos qui ont été consignés dans votre procès-verbal, « Nuun Shea et Tanim étaient amis depuis longtemps. Autrefois, ils avaient fait leurs études et se sont fait ordonner moines ensemble en Thaïlande. Je voulais savoir comment vous aviez eu connaissance de ces informations et si vous aviez d'autres informations à communiquer à la Cour sur les relations qu'entretenaient Rosnin et Nuun Shea à l'époque. »
Answer. I knew from Tanyam, but my foster father, he told me about his relationship with Nuun Shea,
as stated in that document. Donc des liens entre Tanyam et Nuun Shea, comme cela est indiqué dans le document.
Ma dernière question, monsieur le témoin, et j'en aurai terminé, monsieur le président, dans la même réponse, la phrase au-dessus, vous indiquez que vous avez une conversation avec votre père adoptif et qu'il indique « Nuun Shea nous a trahis ». Est-ce que vous pouvez expliquer quelle était la teneur de la conversation à l'époque et pourquoi votre père adoptif avait l'impression que Nuun Shea vous avait trahi?
Why did your adoptive father say that Nuun Shea had betrayed you?
My foster father said such thing.
Ce n'est pas mon père adoptif qui a dit cela.
In fact, told my foster father that perhaps Nuun Shea had betrayed us. That is why the
moi, j'ai dit à mon père adoptif que Nuun Shea avait peut-être trahi, zone, c'est pour la raison pour laquelle les cadres de la zone nord-ouest avaient été exécutés.
Je vous remercie. Je n'ai plus de questions, Monsieur le Président.
Thank you, Mr. President. I have no further questions.
La parole à mes collègues du bureau des coprocureurs. Merci.
I will hand over the floor to my colleagues from the co-prosecutor's office.
National Deputy Co-Prosecutor, good afternoon, Mr. President, Your Honor, everyone in the courtroom. Mesdames good afternoon, Mr. Bonjour, witness. My name is Song Chong-Wan. I have a few questions for you.
Bonjour, Monsieur le Témoin. And I have a
follow-up question from the international co-lead lawyer. You stated that you told your foster father that perhaps Nunchi had betrayed us. So why did you tell such things to your foster father? Answer.
Réponse.
I was thinking that Nunchi was living in Watko, Battambang province.
Vivait à Watko, dans la province de Battambang.
And my foster father married a wife in Phnom.
Mon père adoptif s'était marié.
My foster father lived in Phnom Srok, but he married a wife in Po.
Avec une femme de Po.
People in my zone, in sector or division, were called into a study session and they were all arrested.
Une session d'instruction, ils ont été arrêtés.
And I told my foster father that.
J'ai dit à mon père adoptif.
Nunchi did not betray us. Cat rays are from the northwest zone were not arrested.
This is what I told my foster father.
Deputy co-prosecutor, thank you. Coming back to 17 April 1975, you stated before the chamber that update 10 days
vous avez dit à la chambre
after deliberation, perhaps
it's
shortly before that or
ou peut-être
long, a bit long before that.
Un peu moins de 10 jours après ou un peu plus de 10 jours
SNA
après.
SNA was in charge of radio station.
And
he announced to others that they should lay down weapon, rather it was wine. Who was the chief station unit. So what did he make? What kind of announcement did he make at that time?
And where was the announcement
made?
Answer.
Tawang was the chief of Sector 2 at that time. And he was a professor in charge of internal intellectuals.
C'était un professeur qui s'occupait des intellectuels.
This means that he was in charge of the former intellectuals from a long time.
Tawang
was known widely. That is why he was assigned to make a statement over the radio, so that everyone could recognize and could be persuaded.
Pour que tout le monde puisse être bien convaincu.
Co-prosecutor.
What
did he say in the radio? On the radio.
Qu'a-t-il dit exactement à la radio?
What objective he wanted at that time?
Quel était son objectif à ce moment-là?
Witness, as far as I can recall, I could not give you all the details.
Je ne peux pas vous répondre en détail.
He said that the country had been liberated.
Il a dit que le pays avait été libéré.
And the imperialists collapsed.
Il a parlé de la chute des impérialistes.
So the late King Norodom Sihanouk would come back to be the head of state.
Feu le roi Norodom puisse reprendre le pouvoir.
And he also stated that the war was over, so everyone should follow the announcement by the United Front.
Suivre les instructions données par le Front Uni. Question.
Co-prosecutor. What kind of people was he? What kind of people did he want the message to reach to?
À quelle personne s'adressait-il exactement en faisant passer ce message?
Matt, what?
Answer. He was making announcement to everyone, including
il s'adressait à tout le monde.
Civilians,
civil servants, civils, and all soldiers. Et aux soldats.
Question. After the announcement made by
question.
Him. Who would join with him?
Entendu.
And what kind of people sided with him?
Qui était censé se rallier à lui?
Answer.
Réponse.
Armed forces of Lonol in Badenbong joined with him at that time.
Se sont ralliés à lui.
It was called Gong Sui Tran, and members of this unit laid down weapons.
And weapons were scattered
everywhere on roads.
Ont été éparpillés un peu partout sur les routes.
And later on, these weapons were gathered up and placed in Jiangkache. Question. After they laid down their weapon and joined with him, so what happened to these former Lonol soldiers?
Ils se sont ralliés à lui. Que leur est-il arrivé ensuite? Qu'est-il arrivé à ces anciens soldats de Lonol?
Answer. I have told the court already. Later on, they were invited to go and welcome the late king.
Ils ont été invités à aller accueillir.
They were transported in trucks or vehicles to welcome the late king Norodom Sihanouk. 10 days later, I realized that these people were all killed.
Et 10 jours après, j'ai réalisé que toutes ces personnes avaient été exécutées.
Question. Why did you know that these former Lonol soldiers had been
comment avez-vous appris que ces anciens soldats de Lonol avaient été exécutés?
Answer. I did not know where they
réponse.
Were killed, but I could see that these former soldiers were transported in vehicles or truck near Kampong Tres, the place where I was staying. At first, I felt disappointed with my foster father. I was thinking that I had joined the revolution for so long and I was so committed, why I was not allowed to go and welcome the late king. After communicating messages 2 times, I took rest. And at that time, no told me that these former soldiers had been killed at Duelstadt. So if I had asked them to go with these former soldiers, I would have been killed.
Ces soldats, j'aurais été exécuté.
Question. You stated that these former soldiers were transported in vehicles passing you at that time. What situation did you observe and how many of them were there on vehicles?
Pourriez-vous nous dire combien de
and where were they
transported
to?
Et où ces personnes ont été emmenées?
Answer. They, these former soldiers were transported in the CMC trucks
emmenés à bord de camions CMC
net cover
and
they were shouting "Bravo, the King." They were shouting "Bravo, the King" on the tracks,
and
they
said
that they were all going to welcome the late King.
Ils pensaient tous aller accueillir le roi.
The vehicle was passing me on the road to some round and Kampong Tres.
Sur la route qui menait à Kampong Tres.
So I observed that these former soldiers were being transported,
and they were shouting happily
on the vehicle.
Très heureux à bord de ces véhicules.
Bravo, the late king, and I felt disappointed
bravo,
at that time.
Au roi, et j'étais déçu à l'époque.
Question. What do you know about the policy to gather up all those former
Lonel
soldiers?
À propos de cette politique qui a consisté à réunir les anciens soldats de Lonel?
Answer, I don't get your question.
Je ne comprends
please
pas bien votre question.
It.
Pourriez-vous répéter, s'il vous plaît?
Question. Allow me to rephrase it.
Je vais reformuler.
Do you know why there existed a policy to gather up those former soldiers and later executed them?
Avant de les exécuter.
Madame prosecutor, the witness was asked the question who ordered and why ordered. And answered. The question, the way you are posing it, is suggestive that there was a policy, to which the witness did not confirm such fact. Please rephrase.
Veuillez reformuler, s'il vous plaît.
Listener, Deputy Co-Prosecutor,
la Co-procureur
Madame,
nationale
I refresh my question,
Madame la juge, je vais reformuler ma question.
Do you know why those people were gathered up and tracked out to be sent away and killed?
Emmenés à bord de camion pour être exécutés?
Answer, no,
réponse,
I don't have that
non,
knowledge.
Je ne sais pas.
I don't know at which level of chain of command the order was
je
issued.
Je ne sais pas à quel niveau de la chaîne de commandement l'ordre a été donné.
Question.
Question.
I'd like to ask that you on an issue when your foster father, Ruthnium, sent you to a pilot course in China.
Vous a envoyé suivre un
and
cours
upon your return, he instructed you again to go
par
to China,
suite,
to which you refused.
Chine, mais vous avez refusé.
And he told you that you should attend the pilot course in order to regain the Cambodian territory, Cambodian Crown territory.
Conquérir le territoire du Cambodian Crown.
And my question to you is the following: what was his idea on the recapturing or retake of the Cambodian Crown territory? Did he mean anything else when he told you so?
Que voulait-il dire exactement lorsqu'il vous a parlé de cela?
Answer. I did not fully understand
réponse.
What he said. However, that was what he
dit.
Told me. Maybe
compris,
what he told me was in an incentive for me to return to China, or whether it was his real intention to recapture Cambodian Crown or Nokko Ridge, that is the lands that we had lost in the past, but I refused to return.
Quoi qu'il en soit, j'ai refusé de repartir.
Because my comrades in arms had disappeared. Many of them had disappeared.
Beaucoup d'entre eux avaient disparu.
Question. Now I move on to
question.
Another issue on the visits by leadership
présent,
to Battambang province. You responded to the political lawyer for civil parties that the leaders came to Battambang province once every month or once every fortnight.
Une fois tous les 15
could
jours,
you please confirm whether this was a regular occurrence, commenting from the 17th April 1975,
or at
which particular point in time did it start?
Pourriez-vous nous dire à partir de quand ces visites ont commencé?
Answer. It happened after they all returned from the conclusion of the conference held in Phnom Penh.
Une fois qu'ils sont revenus de la conférence qui avait eu lieu à Phnom Penh.
Question.
Question.
And how many times, if you can recall, they made the visits after the conclusion of the conference?
Suite à cette conférence, savez-vous combien de fois ils sont venus? Vous en souvenez-vous?
Answer. I cannot recall it clearly.
Réponse.
I think it's between two to three times.
Ils sont peut-être venus deux ou trois fois.
Thank you, and Mr. President, I don't have any more questions, and I'd like to give the floor to my international colleague. And thank you, Mr. Witness.
Merci beaucoup, Monsieur le Témoin.
Thank you. Sir, my name is Nicholas Kumjian.
Sir, just
a couple questions. You had mentioned today messages from the zone to the center. My question is focused on April 1975, that month only. As far as you were aware, how many messages per day were sent from the zone to the center?
Du centre vers la zone. Chaque jour.
When the attack campaign commenced, the message was delivered. At least one message was delivered on a daily basis, and a maximum of three messages were sent. For that reason, the three of us, that is, the messengers, would roster ourselves to take the message. And for example, if a message was to be sent in the morning, one of us would deliver the message, and if another one had to be sent in the evening, then another messenger would be assigned. And we always took turn to take the to deliver the message, as it took us quite a long distance to deliver the messages. And that's what happened during the commencement of the attack operation or campaign.
Et cela a commencé donc à partir
when you talk
de
about delivering the messages to the center, are you talking about
question.
Going to a location
de
or to or they are they sent by telegraph?
Ces messages étaient-ils envoyés par télégraphe ou bien vous deviez vous rendre sur place?
I took his message, which was in a sealed envelope.
Réponse, je prenais les messages.
And it had
a
serial number on it. A number
il y avait
is,
des numéros
was
de série sur les enveloppes
then
scellées.
I would take it to office 20.
J'apportais
and
ces
the office 20 would decode the message and
retransmitted
it.
Et le retransmettait.
And likewise, if there was a message from the center,
si
it would reach
the
office 20, decode it,
and
then sealed in an envelope, and my team would deliver the message to him.
So just to be clear, you talked about daily one to three times a day messages from the zone to the center. How many messages per day in April 1975 were there from the center to the zone?
Et combien de messages venaient de la
Mr. President?
Du centre vers la zone chaque jour, ce même
if I make some, may make an observation on this question,
j'aimerais faire une remarque par rapport à cette
that
question.
Might be because of the word use of the word center.
On a entendu parler du centre.
Center, not obviously in the sense of
an office in Phnom Penh, because Phnom Penh still had to be taken. So maybe the witness is confused, or maybe something went wrong in translation.
But
there were messages obviously before 17 April 75 between the zone and the center, because the center as such didn't exist.
So maybe prosecution could ask, could be more specific on this.
Mr. Witness, so we're clear what we're talking about. You seem to understand my question. When I speak of the center, what do you understand? When we say center, what do you understand that to mean?
Que cela signifie-t-il pour vous?
At that point in time, in the northwest zone, they used the word center, and the word center refers to the upper echelon, and it was commonly used since we were in the forest.
Thank you, sir. So my question was, you talked about the amount of messages from the zone to the center. How many messages per day were there from the center to the zone?
Venait du centre et allait vers la zone chaque jour.
I cannot recall it clearly how many messages were sent from the upper echelon or from the center, because sometimes I receive it for the delivery, and sometimes my other messengers receive them.
Parfois c'est d'autres messagers qui le
font. Do you know if those occurred on a regular basis or not? Can you tell us anything about the frequency of messages from the center to the zone?
At the start of the campaign,
au début de la campagne,
I receive a message from the center once every 2 days or 3 days. However, I only speak about myself
jours.
And I cannot speak about the other two messengers, how many messages they received per day or they received from the center at the time.
Thank you. And we appreciate the fact that you limit what you say to things you actually know and have experienced. So, sir, after the Phnom Penh was captured, after the 17th of April 1975, did you ever take messages, carry them to Phnom Penh?
Avez-vous transporté des messages à Phnom Penh?
The 17th April 1975, so I could say it was in July or August that year, the telegraph was actually set up in Rosnim's office.
Le télégraphe dans le bureau de Rosnim.
Rather, it was attached to a vehicle, a military vehicle seized from the former Lunar troop. And it was always with him on mobile on that military vehicle.
Okay, I apologize. My question is, did you ever travel to Phnom Penh with messages from Rosnim?
But
yes,
réponse,
I did.
Oui.
Yes, and I delivered messages to Phnom Penh.
J'ai apporté des
messages. I delivered messages. I delivered rice, durian, and other fruits to Phnom Penh.
D'autres fruits à Phnom Penh.
Sir, when you delivered the messages, who did you actually hand them over to?
Lorsque vous avez apporté ces messages, à qui vous êtes-vous adressé précisément à Phnom Penh?
I delivered the messages to a person
réponse, by name of
Pang.
Des messages à quelqu'un qui s'appelait Pang.
There was a messenger's office situated opposite the Royal Palace.
Qui se trouvait juste en face du Palais Royal.
And that's where messages were delivered.
C'est là que je devais livrer les messages.
And actually, they use a hand-wound phone, and the messages
ils
will be delivered to
Bong,
and the number would be hand-dialed for
le
him.
Numéro.
As for the rice again,
pour lui.
And the fruits again, everything was delivered
les messages,
to
les fruits,
Bong.
Tout devait parvenir à Bong.
Did you ever
question.
Take a group of people with you through Phnom Penh?
Avez-vous jamais accompagné un groupe de personnes à Phnom Penh?
No, I never brought any group of people
réponse.
To Phnom Penh.
Non, je n'ai jamais
And
amené un groupe de personnes à Phnom Penh.
A group of people was brought in. It was only during the time that I brought in those senior cadres to attend the conference.
Did you ever transport Kampuchea Krom people?
Question. Et qu'en était-il du transport des gens du Kampuchea Krom?
Some room long.
Please repeat your question.
Pouvez-vous répéter la question, je vous prie?
You refer to transporting Kampuchea Krom people from where to where?
Well,
just tell me, did you ever transport Kampuchea Krom people through or near Phnom Penh?
Vers Phnom Penh ou proche de Phnom Penh?
I did not transport them by river. And that would lead to Phnom Penh. I went to receive a letter from Pang, and we continued our boat journey to Om Sam Noh.
J'ai continué jusqu'à Om Sam Noh.
And then, with the note, a handwritten
Donc,
note from Pang,
I handed over the
Vietnamese people
Vietnamiens.
As well as the Vietnamese boat to
et
the Vietnamese authority there.
Aux autorités vietnamiennes là-bas.
In fact, when we took or escorted those Vietnamese on their boat, we towed our boat, and when we returned with our towed boat.
Thank you. Sir, you mentioned that you took
Merci.
Messages from Rusnim to Pong, and that on this occasion you received a message from Pong that you turned over to the Vietnamese. What was the function, if you know, of Pong?
Si vous le savez,
do you know, can you tell us anything
Pong?
About his job
dire,
and where he fit in the hierarchy?
Où était-il dans la hiérarchie?
I do not know his function or position. However, at the time he was known as the office chief.
Thank you very much, Mr. Witness. Mr. Witness, you may not know the function of Pong, but I refer your honors to the judgment, paragraphs 211 through 214, and paragraph 383 regarding the function of Pong. Thank you, sir. Mr. President, I have no further questions.
Merci, Monsieur le Président, je n'ai
plus de questions. And then, Mr. President, if you allow me, I would add that Peng was arrested and subsequently executed for treason.
Exécuté pour trahison. Je voulais le souligner.
Madame Tian Kim-song.
Maître Kong-samong.
Kong-samong. Mr. President, I'd like to make a brief observation.
J'ai une remarque.
Through the testimony of the witness, he didn't mention that Peng sent a message to the Vietnamese. However, he made an annotation on the letter so that the witness could take the letter to the Vietnamese authority.
Que le témoin puisse emmener
President,
le message
thank you, everyone.
Le président.
And if the defense counsels and the co-prosecutors and the lead co-lawyers do not have any further questions, it is now the bench turn to put questions to the witness. And Judge Mamba, you may start
juge
first.
Mamba. Vous avez la parole.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Merci, président.
Witness, I have a few questions concerning
Tout Portrait.
The first question is, did you witness the meeting which took place at Pusa Town Hall, in which former Law and Order soldiers and senior officers were gathered after liberation?
No, I did not witness that.
No.
So you, since you didn't witness that, you wouldn't know
comme vous n'en avez pas
what type of officials and the ranks that attended.
De responsables ou d'officiers, leur rang, y ont participé.
Man.
Réponse.
That is correct. I did not know about that or when that meeting was convened.
Pas, je ne sais pas quand cette réunion a été convenue.
Thank you, witness. Thank you, Mr. President.
Merci, Monsieur le témoin. Merci, Président. Le Président.
President, I'd like now to hand the floor to Judge Mongmoni Charya.
Au juge Mongmoni Charya.
Judge Mongmoni Charya, thank you, Mr. President.
Mongmoni Charya. Merci, Président.
Mr. Witness, my questions are about your personal experience.
J'ai des questions sur votre expérience personnelle.
You were a messenger and subsequently you became a deputy chief of the zone, general staff.
Zone, en fait, du quartier, de l'état-major de la zone.
In both capacities, that is before and after 1975,
avant,
did you ever attend any study sessions or training sessions organized by the Democratic Cambodia regime?
Answer,
no, I did not.
Non.
However, I heard something about the contents of the meetings, for example, when the zone
the
cadres were sent
par
for study sessions,
lors des séances
and or when the sector cadres were
les cadres du secteur
attending the study sessions at the zone.
Séances d'études dans la zone.
Question.
You said you heard about some contents of the study session.
Vous dites,
did you hear any particular instructors? Who actually gave instructions through those trainees? Witness, I don't understand your question, John.
Je ne comprends pas votre question, Monsieur le juge.
Question. You said you heard some contents, but you did not hear it. Did you hear about the dissemination of policies? Or what did you hear?
Ne pas savoir, ne pas connaître le contenu de ces réunions. Mais avez-vous entendu parler de la diffusion de ces instructions?
Que saviez-vous?
réponse.
About dissemination of policies.
Entendu because parler de it was disseminated de ses politiques
by him.
Car c'est lui
who I was always with him as a bodyguard, and some study sessions lasted between 2 to 3 days.
Or the short test one
would last 1 day, and the sole instructor would be Rudnim. As for the true study sessions, Otake would be instructor, and usually these two were the main instructors.
Ces deux-là qui étaient les instructeurs principaux.
Tapet was not capable of training those cadres.
Question.
You were with them extensively and you might have known something for the period either prior to or after 1975. Can you tell the chamber how the order or the instructions from the upper echelons were implemented? Answer, before 17
April 1975.
Their trainings focus on popular democratic revolution.
Les sessions d'études portaient surtout sur la révolution populaire démocratique. And the main
content of the sessions were to make the popular democratic revolution and to
d'encourager la révolution populaire démocratique et défendre le pays.
And after the conclusion of the conference held in Phnom Penh, the trainings were given to cadres at the sector level.
Des formations de cadres au niveau du secteur.
Tanyum engaged in a one-day training, where Tucker engaged in the two-day training course.
And actually, I took them
through these two training locations. By that time, the tone of the session changed from the popular democratic revolution to the socialist revolution.
La révolution socialiste.
That's what I can recall.
C'est ce dont je me souviens.
And they also spoke about the establishment of cooperatives.
De la création des coopératives.
Actually, by that time, I did not know what cooperatives were, though I remember the gist of their training programs.
De l'essentiel de leur programme de formation.
And in general, on the issue of documentation, I do not know much about whether those cadres would go to the bases and disseminate the experience they learned through the study sessions.
Question.
Were you aware at the time of the change of command, for example, the level of authorities at various levels?
Les pouvoirs aux différents niveaux.
Answer, no, réponse. I was not aware of the authority at various levels.
Non, je ne connaissais pas les pouvoirs des différents niveaux.
My understanding was that if you were in charge of food supply or logistics, you would deal with the food supply or logistics issues alone. And if you were to deal with the forces, then you were solely in charge in dealing with that.
C'était votre seule responsabilité.
There were two organizational structures.
Il y avait deux structures organisationnelles.
One was the secretary.
L'une était le secrétaire.
Or in the military, it would be the commissioner or the commander.
Et c'était le commandant ou un commissaire.
And the commissioner would be in charge of the management of the organization.
La gestion de l'organisation.
And the commander would be in charge of the troops itself. And the same structure applies to the zone level. There will be a zone party secretary,
secrétaire de parti de zone,
his deputy, and the zone commander.
Et le commandant de zone.
Question. Were you aware of the policy dissemination
regarding la diffusion des politiques?
The arrest of people, for example, those who made mistakes or who violated the policies of the party.
Vis-à-vis des politiques du parti.
Did you hear them talking about the policy towards the former Lunar soldiers after the 17 April 1975 liberation? Answer. To that point, I did not have a great understanding.
Je ne comprenais pas très bien ce point.
I did not know much about why people were evacuated or why those people were gathered up to receive the king.
Rassemblés pour aller accueillir le roi.
Nor the arrest of people who were their own cadres.
L'arrestation de gens qui étaient leur propre cadre.
However, later on, when I put my concerns to questions and to Nam,
posé des
I was told those people were advised to attend study sessions in Phnom Penh. However, it turned out that they were arrested.
En fait, ils ont été arrêtés.
President, let me rest for 1 minute for the changing of DVD.
Pour changer le DVD.